Welcome to RiskWatch, I'm Jonathan Ferguson. Maximizing your BSA-AML system and making it work for your institution can feel like trying to survive on a deserted island. Your best efforts may sometimes seem fruitless. Ken Engel of AdviseX is here with some tips to help your BSA-AML system thrive. Ken?
Thanks, Jonathan. You've seen the reality TV show. Contestants are dropped off somewhere that seems utterly beautiful. But before long, that beauty begins to give way to the inevitable challenges of the land. Even beautiful places can deal some harsh challenges. The contestants struggle, and sometimes they seem completely lost and disheartened. But then there's a challenge, and the prize is help from a native of the area. This may not seem like much, but in the expert's hands, what just was a plant becomes a healing balm. Leaves become useful traps to capture food. The native expert shows you how much was there all along. Sometimes it just takes that insightful and knowledgeable eye. BSA AML system users often find that what was once promised as a beautiful system sometimes proves to be a bit hostile. These systems, which are designed with the intent of detecting potentially suspicious or outlier activity, can sometimes produce so much noise that nothing else can be heard. These systems can seem more damaging than helpful. It is a frustrating position even when efforts to fix the system have proven less than successful. Our experience in conducting validations of almost every BSA-AML system in the market has given us a few very important insights. One, every system has value. Two, the need for strong case management is ever present. And three, when systems fail, it is usually because of a lack of data. But that doesn't mean that the systems can't be fixed. Like our earlier analogy, any organization has much that can make any system effective. The key is using the full range of the land and ensuring that all key components are used to their fullest. Step one in this process is to optimize the AML system. System optimization focuses on using the full extent of the system to tighten down loose areas and eliminate unnecessary elements. Step two in the process focuses on the strengths of case management. Frankly, no system can be effective without strong case management. It is vital to be able to analyze the outcome of each case so that you can determine what's working and what isn't. Systems with sound case management can prove exceptionally powerful, but only if fully implemented. Step three is about living off the land. Most organizations are only using a small fraction of their resources to survive. This means that their AML systems may be doing all they can, but that isn't enough. In step three, the goal is to find resources already available to the organization that could be a powerful element for the system. Naturally, when those elements can be added into the system, they should be. But even if additional elements aren't available, many times it's a case of taking existing resources, combining them with the AML system, and giving the organization a far more robust, efficient, and effective approach to AML monitoring and reporting. Surviving AML in today's challenging world often means taking full advantage of all resources. An organization that has shown all the elements that can be used and the way those resources may be deployed can go from not surviving to thriving.
Thanks, Ken. For more information on AdviseX's Optimization Consulting Enhancement Alert Notification Solution, or OCEANS, please visit riskinbox.com/resources. I'm Jonathan Ferguson for RiskWatch. Thanks for watching.